Everybody will say, amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Before we sit down, amen, let us move on to our the reading of the word today. Hallelujah. There's only one verse that I have prepared for this afternoon, and it is in Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 8 in the NIV version. Amen. And if we are ready, let us all read together with understanding. 1, 2, 3, go. See, I have given you this land. Go in and take possession of the land the Lord swore he would give you to your fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and to their descendants after them. May the Lord add blessing to the reading of His mighty word. We can all be sit down in the presence of God. Thank you for music. Amen. Good afternoon, everyone. How is everyone today?
Great.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Isa lang ba ang great? Praise the Lord. Welcome po sa ating worship and healing service at 4 p.m. Even to our viewers, amen, in the YouTube channel, in the Facebook, in the live stream, welcome po. Amen. And today is the beginning of Sunday for the month of August. Amen. And we have a new theme for this month. Amen. And our theme for this month is about possessing the land. And our theme entitled Revival, A Call to Possess the Land. Sabihin po natin, Revival, a call to possess the land. Amen? There is a call for us to possess the land. It might not be literally land, amen, but, you know, in other translation, in other meaning, that, you know, there are things that God has prepared to each and every one of us. Amen? And today, I hope and I pray that we will, you know, understand ano ba ang mga piniprepare ng Lord sa buhay natin. Amen? Like the reason why we are called by the Lord is for us to be understand what are the things that we need to possess. Amen? While we are here on earth. Amen? And as my part of introduction, you know, in the Old Testament, we can see that when Moses led the people of Israel out of Egypt, we can see that in the book of Exodus, that, and even in the book of, you know, Deuteronomy, that when God called Moses to deliver the Israelite out of Egypt, amen, makikita po natin that God chose Moses to lead the Israelite out of Egypt. Amen. And, you know, the Bible called it Exodus. Amen. But for the Lord, it is more about salvation. Because when God hears the cry of the Israelite, when they are being, you know, oppressed, when they are in bondage, when they are, you know, experiencing hardship in Egypt, the Lord heard their cry. Amen. And for God, even though the Bible called it Exodus, for God, it is more like a salvation. Amen? Because when Exodus happened, the people of the Israelites ultimately freed from the terrible bondage from the Egyptians. You know, the Lord saved the parting of the Red Sea, the manna, the clouds of pillar by day, and the clouds of fire, the pillar of fire by night. Makikita po natin, they are all part of God's salvation to the Israelites. And that is in the Old Testament. And if you look on the New Testament, you know, it is the same idea that we can see that when Jesus Christ died on the cross, makikita po natin, when Jesus Christ died in the cross of Calvary, you know, the good thing about it is when Jesus Christ died on the cross and we are going to accept Him and believe in Him, and then we will receive salvation. Amen. And the good thing about it is not, you know, for specific people. Just like when, you know, God delivered the Israelites from the Egyptians, it's all only for the Israelites. Amen. But when the Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross, it's not limited to the Jews. Amen. It is for everyone who will believe in Him. Amen. That's why salvation is our entrance into the kingdom of God. Sabihin po natin, entrance. Salvation is the entrance to the kingdom of God. Why? The Bible declares in John chapter 14, verse 6, the Lord Jesus Christ says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me. It is the Lord Jesus Christ who's speaking here, amen, and he's saying that salvation, amen, is our ticket, is our entrance to the kingdom of God. Without the Lord Jesus Christ, we cannot enter the kingdom of God, because John 14 verse 6 is clearly saying in there that Jesus Christ is the only way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through Jesus Christ. Amen. And going back to the Old Testament, makikita po natin, amen, God's desire is to bring the people of Israel into a promised land. When God asked Moses to bring out all the Israelites into the land of Egypt, God's desire is to bring the people of Israel into the promised land. A land flowing with milk and honey, a land that is productive to its beauty and fruitfulness. That is in the Old Testament. But when we receive the Lord Jesus Christ as our own personal Savior in the New Testament, makikita po natin, it is the same desire of our Lord Jesus Christ for us to experience abundant life. Amen. God just did not, you know, die on the cross for us to be saved. God did not just die on the cross for us to go to heaven, but at the same time, God died for you and for me so that we can have a life that is in abundance. Amen. Makikita po natin sa John chapter 10 verse 10, it says in there, the thief's purpose is to steal and kill and destroy, but here, the Lord Jesus Christ is saying to you and to me, but my purpose, why I came here on earth, is for you to give you a rich and satisfying life. Amen? That is another purpose of God for you and for me. Not just to go to heaven, but while we are here living on earth, amen, we will experience rich and satisfying life. Sabi po natin, rich and satisfying life. Amen? And how can we experience those rich and satisfying life? Because along with the salvation the Lord Jesus Christ has given us, amen, He also delivered us from the penalty of sin. He also delivered us, amen, from the penalty of sin and healed us from the effects of sin. Because we need to understand, amen, that there are effects of sin in our lives. That when we sin, that when we are sinners, amen, there is effects in us and it, you know, hinders the blessing, it hinders the fruitfulness of what God has promised to each and every one of us. Amen? Kaya nga po, God's desire is for us to experience those abundant life. Amen. Even in the Old Testament, even the Israelites, when they came out of Egypt, God's desire is for them to go to the promised land, a land flowing with milk and honey. That's the purpose. That's His desire. Amen. To release them from any bondages. Pero, sabi ng Lord, no, going back to our verse in Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 8, it says in there, the Lord is saying to the Israelites, see, I have given you this land. Go in and take possession of the land. Amen? So here in this verse, makikita po natin that God already given the Israelite the land. He already given it to them. And the Lord is saying, go in and take possession of the land. Meaning, it's already. Parang pagkain yan. Amen? You know, our children, right? When their parents prepare the food for them, it's already on the table. Okay, the food is already prepared. Just go and eat it. And what they only need to do is just sit down on the table, grab the spoon and fork, and eat it because it's all ready. Right? It's the same thing here, amen, when God told the Israelite, okay, I already given you this land, the promised land. Just go in and take possession of it. So wala na sana problema, right? But the thing is, you know, makikita po natin, going back to my PowerPoint, amen, that there is a dilemma. Amen. There is a dilemma. There is a problem. Why? Kasi nga po, sabi ng Lord, go in and take possession of it. Wala na sana dapat kahirap-hirap, right? There shouldn't be any problem at all. You just need to, you know, take it. But the thing is, makikita po natin, reading the book of, you know, Deuteronomy, amen, eh, sadly, the Israelite did not really claim the promised land. Because when, you know, when the Israelite left Egypt, makikita po natin in the Bible, in the book of Joshua, that we can see that almost everyone who came out of Egypt died. So lahat po nung lumabas sa Egypt, namatay. They all died in the wilderness. They did not reach the promised land that God has given them. Why? What is the problem? Makikita po natin yan sa Joshua chapter 5 verse 6 in the New Living Translation. Ano po sabi doon? The Israelites have traveled in the wilderness for 40 years until all the men who were old enough to fight in the battle when they left Egypt had died. Pause po muna tayo doon. Do you think, you know, if God knows that they will die in the wilderness, do you think God will give them the promised land? Of course not. Right? What's for? If they're just gonna roam around in the wilderness for 40 years knowing that they will die there anyway. Pero ano po ang main reason why they did not reach the promised land? In the next sentence, sabi po doon, amen, for they had disobeyed the Lord, and the Lord vowed he would not let them enter the land he had sworn to give us, a land flowing with milk and honey. So it's not just about, you know, how long they traveled. It's not just about, you know, it's not about wandering in the desert. The main problem why they did not enter the promised land, it is because of disobedience. It is because of sin. Amen? Imagine, disobedience, you know, in Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 2, I think I have it in my PowerPoint. Do you know how many days that the Israelite need to travel from Egypt to the promised land? Sabi po sa Deuteronomy chapter 1 verse 2, it says in there, it takes 11 days to go from Horeb to Kadesh Barnea by the Mount Seir road. 11 days ang travel time. And how long they took? 40 years. Actually, 40 years, and they did not even reach the promised land. They spent 40 years in the wilderness and still not reaching the promised land. Ganun po katindi. That's how disobedience, that's how sin affects the promises of God in our lives. Amen. Kaya nga po in this present time, too many Christians today are saved but die in the wilderness. Ang daming Christian, amen, they are saved but the promises that God has given them died in the wilderness. Imbis na tayo yung, you know, imbis na Christians are the one who, you know, experiencing good life, instead of, you know, Christians are experiencing, you know, and yet, tayo yung huli, we are the tail, we are the borrower. Well, in fact, God said, you will not be the tail, but you will be the head. The Bible also says that you will lend and you will not borrow. Pero baliktad. Right, where is the promises of God in there? And maybe because we have a problem. is the same problem that the Israelites experienced in the wilderness. Maybe there is a disobedience into our hearts. Amen? There are things that we are doing that we thought that it's okay. There are things that we are doing in our life that we thought it's good, and yet in the eyes of God, it's not good. It is disobedience. Amen? You know, the hope, the joy, the peace, even the love of God that we are supposed to be experiencing, you know, most Christians, a lot of Christians, you know, all those things die in the wilderness. That's why a lot of Christians are defeated, weak, simpleng problema, eh, natatalo tayo. Amen. They fail to possess the many promises of God prepared for them. And it's just because of disobedience. They are not experiencing, you know, a life that is to the full. You know, the life mentioned in John chapter 10, the abundant life mentioned in John chapter 10, verse 10, A, B, amen. You know, it is not necessarily a long life. The abundant life that the Lord is telling in John chapter 10, verse 10, you know, it's not a life free of sorrow. Sometimes we base all those things that, oh, I'm blessed because I have a long life. Oh, I'm blessed because I don't have any problem. Abundant life is not about, you know, free from heartache. Abundant life is not just about free of tragedy. But a true abundant life, I mean, is one in which we are content in knowing that God's grace is more sufficient than us. Because we know, if we know, amen, that God is in control of everything, His love and His mercy will make us through in difficult times. That is abundant life. That even though there is difficulties in life, that even though there's problems, mountains of problems, amen? When we wake up in the morning, we know that there's still hope. We know that there's solution to all those things. And that we know that we are not alone in this world. Amen? Because the Bible promises that He will never leave us nor forsake us. And God's favor never ends. That is the abundant life Jesus is offering to those who believe and trust in Him. Amen? Now, you know, God's promise, there's always a promise of God. Not only into the Israelites, but even us today, you know, who are following the Lord Jesus Christ, God has a promise to us. And on my next slide, as a follower of Christ, amen, sometimes it can often feel like we, our lives is a constant battle to possess our own promised land. Amen? Minsan, you know, we think that, why is my answered prayers not coming? Or why, you know, the promises of God, I always keep reading the book, the Bible, and, you know, He has so many promises, and yet, I don't experience them. And the Word of God is filled with so much promises. Kaya nga po, if we ask ourselves, you know, if I ask you this afternoon, what is your promised land? Amen? What kind of promises you receive from the Lord? What kind of, you know, prayer request that you have uttered to the Lord and waiting for an answer? What are those promises that you are holding on? It might be spiritual. It might be relationship. No, your relationship with God, you will continue to grow, will mature. Or even relationship with your family, husband and wife relationship, parents and children relationship, siblings relationship, or maybe your promised land that you are waiting is maybe you want to be freed from any sin, from any bondage, from any addiction, or maybe it's something else. But no matter what it is, my dear brothers and sisters, you need to believe and you will receive it. We need to believe and we will receive it. We should not doubt. Sabi mo natin, doubt. Kasi ito po yung minsang problema natin eh. Amen? When we are waiting long and long and long, we doubt, we discourage, or dismayed. But I need you to take these promises from the Lord. In Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3, it says in here, ano po sabi noon? In the contemporary English version, it says in there, at the time I have decided, it is the Lord who speaks here. Amen? And the God is saying to you and to me, at the time I have decided, my words will come true. Whatever the Lord speak, whatever the Lord has promised to you, amen, the Bible is saying that His words will come true. You can trust what I say about the future. It may take a long time, but keep on waiting, it will happen. Sabihin mo sa katabi mo, it will happen. On the other side, don't worry, it will happen. Amen? Kasi minsan, maybe it's just a test of patience for us. Last Saturday, don't watch, someone, you know, like we have a sister who testified that she's been waiting for 14 years on her prayer request. Took 14 years. What if she give up, you know, 13 years and 11 months and 30 days? Isang araw na lang. Diba? Kaya, you know, when we don't get the answer to our prayer, doesn't mean that, you know, the Lord did not hear it. It doesn't mean that it will not happen. As the Bible declares in Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3, it may take a long time, but keep on waiting. It will happen. Amen? Amen. It will happen. Palakpak mo natin ang Diyos sa buhay. Kaya nga po, these promises of God, you know, our theme for this month is to possess the land, to possess your promises, to possess what God has promised to you when you accept Him as your Lord and personal Savior, when you decided to follow Him, when you are reading His Word. There's so many promises in this book. Amen? And makikita po natin that as we, our, you know, as we claim the promises of God, we need to take possession of it. Sabi po natin, take possession. We need to take possession of what God has in store for each and every one of us. You need to take possession of what God has given you. Sabi nga po sa James chapter 1, verse 17, in the NIV version, wala po yata sa aking PowerPoint, but it says in there, James chapter 1, verse 17, every good and perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of the heavenly lights, who does not change like shifting shadows. And if you are the child of God, then you must possess it. Amen. Kaya if we are right now, if we are living in mediocrity, and if we are living defeated, or not having what we are supposed to have, amen, then we need to do something about it. Kasi ito na yung promise eh. I have given you already. God has given you already. It's already written in the Bible. Hindi yung sinusulat pa lang. No, it's already here. It's already been said. It's already been done. Amen? And all we need to do is to claim it. But if we have a problem claiming it, but if we have problem processing it, maybe these three steps, amen, that I'm going to share to you will help us claim what God has given to you and to me. Amen? Praise the Lord. Kaya nga po, let me share you three actions to take possession of what God has promised to your life. Amen? Number one po is makikita po natin that we need to maintain a sanctified life. Sabi po natin, sanctified. For us to be able to conquer, for us to be able, amen, to possess the promised land that God has prepared for us, we need to maintain a sanctified life. We all know what sanctification means, right? Because I think, you know, we always hear it. What is sanctification? You know, sanctification means being set apart for God and separated from sin. That is sanctification. So we need to be separated for God and we need to be separated from sin. That is sanctification. And sanctification is very, very, very important in the sight of God. Amen. It is the key to possessing the land. Remember Moses. Remember Moses. Moses did not enter the promised land. Why? Because of the mistake that he has committed. Ano po ba yung mistake na nangyari? In Numbers chapter 20 verse 7 to 12, ata po yun. In Numbers chapter 20 verse 7 to 12, amen, when the Israelites are complaining again, they don't have water, they are thirsty, they don't have anything to drink, right? And maybe Moses is fed up already of all this, you know, murmur. Moses already fed up with this, you know, complaining for 40 years. Day after day, oh, I don't have anything to eat. I don't have anything to drink. It's better in Egypt. Why you brought us here to die in the wilderness? Those are the complaints. And then God says to Moses, okay, give them something to drink. But the Lord said to Moses, speak to the rock. But what Moses did is, he strike the rock. Twice pa. God said, speak to the rock. Moses strike the rock. Sino po yung mga I think in all of us experience yung naiinis tayo, di ba? Minsan pa nagagalit tayo sa mga anak natin, right? Yan, tsaksak mo sa bumangam yan. Yung ganun ba? Si Moses siguro, itong mga to, di ba? So instead of speaking to the rock, he strike the rock. Sige, malunod kayo sa tubig. Diba? Mainis ka talaga eh. Pero, siguro, tao laang, right? Sometimes we make mistakes. We sin. And that simple matter caused Moses not to enter the promised land. Pero nakita niya yung promised land. Right? Makita pa natin in the Bible, God did not allow Moses to enter the promised land, but Moses, God brought Moses to the top of the mountain, and God shows Moses, oh, that's gonna be the promised land. You can only see it from afar, but you will not enter it. Because sabi ng Lord, amen, na-dishonor ang Lord sa harapan ng mga Israelites. he was dishonored. And that, God considered it as sin. You know, a lot of Israelites grumbled as well. You know, alam natin, everyone died. You know how many people died in the wilderness? Sabi ng Clarks, it's over 1,078,000 Israelites died in the wilderness. That's a lot. Sabi ng Bible, the Exodus, it's about 600,000 Israelite men on foot left Egypt plus their wives and their children. And then here, according to Clark's survey, it's 1.78 million Israelites died in the wilderness, wandering over 40 years. That is the consequence of sin. Sabi po natin, consequence of sin. That's why we don't take sin lightly. And it's not only affecting ourselves, but it also affects your family. It also affects your children. Remember, amen, there is curse on sin. And curses, amen, transferred up to a fourth generation. That's why sometimes we think, you know, I thought when I get born again, my life's gonna be good. No, it's not. Unless you live a sanctified life, then yes, you will live an abundant life. But if you have sin lingering in your hearts, then we have a problem. And the person who reached the promised land is no other than Joshua. We all know Joshua. Joshua is the aide of Moses. Parang utusan. He's the helper. Wherever Moses go, Joshua goes. And you know, what the good thing about Joshua, I believe, he's an observant man. He knows what's happening around. He knows when Moses mistakes. He knows, you know, when he knows why God hates sin. He's probably there, you know, when he strike the rock. Oh, no, no. And he learned from it. Joshua learned from it. That's why makikita po natin in Joshua chapter 3 verse 5, when Moses is dead and God asked Joshua to take over Moses' responsibility, amen, Joshua knows what to do. And what he said to the Israelites in Joshua chapter 3 verse 5, it says it there, and Joshua said to the people, sanctify yourselves. For tomorrow, the Lord will do wonders among you. Sanctify yourself. Again, God gave Joshua the command, go and possess the land. And yet, Joshua knows, teka muna, before we possess the land, maybe we need to sanctify ourselves first para sigurado. Because we don't know. Right? He knows the importance of sanctification. To God, He takes sin seriously. And even in the Bible, look at the many men and women of God in the Bible. If we sin, God will deal with you. Those men and women in the Bible, when they sin, God deal with them. David, a man after God's own heart, when he sinned, hindi naman natuwa sa kanya ang Lord. Right? Solomon, King Solomon, when he had everything in this world, and yet when he sinned, God take away the kingdom from him. King Saul, when he sinned, God even regretted that God made him king of Israel. Si Moses, si Jonah, right? When he sinned, instead of going to Nineveh, he went to Tarsus. Kaya mag-iingat po tayo ng mga ginagawa natin. We thought that it's good. Make sure that it's the will of God. Otherwise, we are sinning in the sight of God. And what happened to him? Kala niya, makakataka siya. Right? But he was eaten by dilis. Ano? By whale. Masyadong maliit yung dilis para kay Jonah. Look at Ananias and Sapphira. What happened to this couple? Nagbigay naman sila, right? You know? They sell their property. Yung pinagbilahan ng property nila, they sell their property, and then the money that, you know, that they got from selling the property, they gave it to the church. But why they died? Instantly. Because they lied to the Holy Spirit. They lied to the Holy Spirit. Kaya nga po, come to think of it, you know, going back to the life of Moses, kung titignan natin, Moses, his sacrifice, his service to God, there's no question about it. Right? When he was in the wilderness, Moses, when God called him, right? Moses had so many excuses to God that he doesn't want to follow God. And yet, with all those excuses, he still followed God. Sabi niya, Lord, I don't know how to speak. And then, you know, Moses scared of Pharaoh, and yet he still went to Egypt. For years and years, he hears the grumbling, he hears the complaining of the people of Israelite. He even said, God, anak ko ba itong mga to? Are these people came from my, you know, why do I need to suffer from these people? If we're gonna look on how Moses served God, if we're gonna look on how sacrifice Moses has given to the Israelite, eh, Moses is very much entitled of everything. Right? He's entitled for everything. And he can even say a lot of things to God. And, you know, for the last 40 years, it's only one mistake. Simple lang naman ang mistake. Lumabas din naman yung water, right? When Moses strike the rock, water still come out. Okay lang sana if the water did not come out. Pero, just one mistake and cause him not to enter the promised land. You know what I'm getting here? It's not about how long we've been a Christian. It's not about how long we serve God. It's not about, you know, because some people are entitled of everything. Oh, I'm the one who started the Bible study here. I'm the king. Oh, without me, this, you know, this music, this stage here is not gonna go. I'm the talented person here. I serve God, you know, since the beginning of time. I experienced so many things in this church. I am titled of something. That's why, you know, God always look on today. Whatever you have done today, God is more concerned of it. It's the same thing what happened to Moses. When he was commanded to speak on the rock, but instead strike the rock, the privilege of entering the promised land was gone. Amen? And the problem with those people who are self-entitled, if they don't get what they want, if they don't get what they want, they complain, they murmur, they rebel, they pinpoint people, or because of them, it's not looking at themselves. What have I done? Maybe, my dear brothers and sisters, today, maybe sin is the cause of us not experiencing the fullness of life. Maybe it is the sin that, you know, caused us not to receive that promise that God has given to each and every one of us. We have been a Christian for so long, and yet we still live not experiencing the good things that God has prepared to all of to you. Maybe it's the sin that hinders us in possessing the promises that God has in store for you. Kaya nga po, it's just a warning for each and every one of us. God cannot be mocked. God knows what is happening. Dapat hindi po natin tinatanggal always yung God factor. That God knows what is happening. Amen? Pero, we need to take seriously of how sin can affect the promises that God has given to each and every one of us. Sa Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16 to 19, makikita po natin dito, no? Sabi ng Bible, there are six things the Lord hates. Ah, hindi pala. Pito pala, sabi ng Bible. No, seven things He detests. Sabi doon, haughty eyes. Ano ba yung haughty eyes? Masamang tingin? May ibig sabihin? A lying tongue. Hands that kill the innocent. A heart that plots evil. Feet that race to do wrong. A false witness who pours out lies. And a person who sows discord in a family. Not only your family, but God's family. Church family. Kaya nga po, warning lang po ito sa atin. Amen. Baka kasi mamaya nami-miss natin tong verse na to eh. When we are reading the Bible. That's why, wherever you go, wherever we go, maybe sometimes we thought that, oh, this church is not for me anymore, I just go somewhere else. Well, if you have that sin in your heart wherever you go, it's the same thing. Ikaw pa magdadala ng problema dun sa matahimik na church. Amen? If we have kept that iniquities and sin in our heart, there's no way we will possess the promised land. No way. It's time to repent and turn back from this wickedness. You might think that you're okay today. You might think that, oh, I'm doing good. I think I'm okay. Well, we'll see. Amen? Amen? sanctification must be done before we can go to this next step. Ano po yung second step? Back to my PowerPoint. Our second step is we need to engage in spiritual battle. Sabihin po natin, engage in spiritual battle. We need to engage into a spiritual battle. You know, possessing the land. When God asked Joshua to possess the land, amen, makita po natin, it's not easy. Because there are people already living in that place. And they need to take them out on that place so that they can possess the land. Amen. And as soon as the Israelites enter the land, they need to engage in battle. You know, in Jericho, right? We all know this story, like the wall of Jericho, right? There are already people living in there, but God says, you possess that Jericho. You need to take them out. They need to engage in battle. Amen. And these cities are not just an ordinary cities. They are strong, they are powerful. Even they have giants in there. But Joshua and people of Israel have to engage in battle. They need to win it before they will possess it. Kaya nga po tayo, amen, God has given us the promises, but sometimes it's easy to claim the promises, but you know, there's another step that we need to do. We need to engage in spiritual battle. Amen? Alam mo nyo ba na, you know, as nag-research po ako, you know how many promises of God in the Bible? Sabi po ng Google, amen, there are about 8,810 promises of God in the Bible. Ang dami, right? Ilan lang naman ang kailangan mo dun? But there are 8,810 promises of God in the Bible that you can claim. All of them are ready to possess. But the problem is, do you think Satan will allow you to have it? No. Satan does not want you to have it. That's why you need to engage in spiritual battle. When your answered prayer is not there yet, maybe someone is holding your promises. Amen? Kaya nga po, have you ever asked yourself, why I am missing something? God said this, but I don't have it. Or am I missing something? The Lord promised this, but why I don't have it? I don't experiencing it. Amen? Kasi po sa John chapter 10 verse 10b, sabi po doon, di ba, the Lord Jesus Christ came here on earth, what? For us to what? To have a rich and satisfying life. But on the other hand, there's another one who came here on earth too. Ano siyang ginagawa niya? The thief comes only to steal, to kill, and destroy. That's why Satan doesn't want you to have the promises. He's here to come, to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He doesn't want you to have it. That's why you need to engage in spiritual battle. Amen? We need to win it. We need to fight it. We need to fight the battle and win it to possess God's promises. Kasi po, this life here on earth, amen, we are not fighting, you know, kasi kagaya niyan, galit ka sa katabi mo, hindi naman yan ang kaaway mo eh. It's not the physical person that you are fighting for. It is the spirit. Even your husband, your wife, you're mad with your husband. No, it is the spirit. Sabi po sa Ephesians chapter 6 verse 12, amen. It says in there, for we are not fighting against flesh and blood. So you are not fighting with your husband. You are not fighting with your children. You are not fighting with your parents. You are not fighting with your brothers and sisters in Christ. We are fighting against the evil rulers and authorities of the unseen world. Against mighty powers in this dark world and against evil spirit in the heavenly realms. Ito ang kalaban natin. That's why if there's a problem, amen, we should know how to rebuke the spirit. Pag may problema sa church, ano ang ginagawa mo? What do you do? Are you kneeling down and interceding for the people in the church? Are you kneeling down and interceding for your leaders? Are you kneeling down and interceding, you know, for the church? Because there's an evil rulers and authorities of a sin world that try to destroy the church? Or you're using yourself to be the accessory of Satan? Remember, we are not fighting against flesh and blood. What we are fighting against principalities, against evil rulers of the unseen world. Amen? Kaya nga po, if you don't have, you know, if you are not still receiving our promised land, maybe we need to engage in battle. We need to fight Satan. Kasi si Daniel, even Daniel, in Daniel chapter 10, verse 12 to 13, ano po sabi doon? Daniel, when he prayed, sabi po ng Bible, amen, in verse 12, it says in there, then he said, don't be afraid, Daniel, since the first day you began to pray for understanding and to humble yourself before God, your request has been heard in heaven. So maybe, when you start praying and kneeling down and ask God for these promises, God already heard it and sent the answer to your prayer. Pwede yun, di ba? Kasi it's the same thing with Daniel. When he start praying and kneeling down, and then his request has been heard in heaven. Pero, ano nangyari? In the next verse, in verse 13, but for 21 days, the spirit prince of the kingdom of Persia blocked my way. So, si Gabriel, he's already delivering your answered prayer. He already delivering the answered prayer of Daniel, but he was blocked for 21 days in the heavenly realms. Kaya nga po, pag meron pang hindi numarating ang answered prayer natin, maybe it's still there, hanging in the middle. That's why we don't give up. We wage war. We pray. We intercede. We come against the principalities. We come against the demonic spirit. Amen. Sometimes we thought, oh, my husband will not change anymore. He's gonna be the same yesterday, today, and forever. No. Maybe it's time for you to kneel down and pray and intercede. Right? Because we are not fighting against flesh and blood. We are fighting against the ruler of darkness. And sabi po doon, and then Michael, one of the archangels, eto na po yung help. Dumating na yung help ni Gabriel. Gabriel is the messenger, and then Michael is, nobody, sabi nila, nobody mess with Michael. Because one of the archangels came to help me and I left him there with the spirit prince of kingdom of Persia. So, umalis na si Gabriel, delivering the message, delivering the answered prayer, and then Michael there still fighting against the principalities of darkness. Amen. Kaya nga po, all the promises of God are available already. It's already coming down from heaven. All gifts, good and perfect gifts, it's already coming down from heaven. Pero, tingnan po natin. We need to open our spiritual eyes. We need to open our spiritual understanding. Maybe, Our promised land is hanging up there. And it needs help. It needs prayer. Amen. Because sometimes we thought it's missing or it's been delayed, but maybe it's someone's blocking in there. That's why, what do we do to engage in spiritual battle? We need to stand on a scripture. On my next slide. To engage into battle, we need to stand on scripture. Ano bang sabi ng scripture? We need to stand on a scripture. We need to stand on the word of God. We need to stand on the truth. That's why it's very important that we are reading our Bible. Amen. It's okay to, you know, watch YouTube. It's okay to watch, you know, search in Google, good teachings. But don't rely on there. You need to read your Bible. Ano ba sabi ng Bible? Amen. That's why reading the scripture is very crucial in possessing the promised land, in possessing the land. Because we cannot stand on something that we don't know. Right? We cannot stand on something that we don't know. Another thing that we need to do to engage in spiritual battle is we need to keep on praying. Sabi mo na, praying. We need to pray. We need to intercede. We need to pull down the strongholds. We need to rebuke the works of Satan. We need to cancel any attacks and plans of Satan in our lives, in our family. Remember, the thief comes to kill, to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Ang gusto ng Lord, magagandang bagay. Pero ang Satan, ang gusto niya, magkagulo. Kaya, if you have a spiritual discernment, madidiscern mo naman eh, it is from God or not. Right? Do you think God likes division? Of course not. Eh, kanino galing yun? Eh, yun nga, oh, destroy. Satan. Huwag tayo papagamit kay Satan. We need to keep on praying. We need to stand on scripture. Ano ba natutunan natin? Eh, ang problema kasi, the reason why we are being deceived because we don't read the Bible and apply it to our lives. Right? But if you are applying the Word of God in your life, and you know the truth, you will not be deceived. Stand on scripture, keep on praying, and last is worship as a lifestyle. We need to keep on worshiping God. You know there is power in worship. The wall of Jericho, sabi nila, the wall of Jericho is like so thick. Like no one can, you know, really make it fall down. Pero, sa sigaw lang ng mga Israelite, bumagsak. Right? They march around the wall. And then sabi ng Lord, after 7 days, no talking. Or after 6 days, no talking. Quiet lang kayo. But on the 7th day, you need to shout. Hallelujah! Bagsak ang wall of Jericho. That's why there's power in worship. Amen? God used those worship to deliver the hands of God so that we can fight against spiritual darkness. Amen? Kaya nga po, we need to engage into battle. We cannot just sit and, you know, just observe. We need to, even into your family, if you are experiencing problem in your family, we need to discern it. Maybe the devil is trying to attack our family. Right? Our children, our parents, our siblings. That's why it's very important that we know the works and wiles of the devil. And if we realize that someone is blocking our blessing, someone is blocking our promises, then we need to engage in war by reading the word, praying, and worshiping the Lord. Amen? Hindi yung, oo nga ka kaagad. Hindi mo naman alam yung other story, oo nga ka kaagad. Right? Kneel down and pray. Ask God for direction. The Lord will direct you. The Lord will lead you to the right path. The Word of God is the lamp to your feet, a light to your path. That's why when you are reading the Bible, kahit madilim, the Word of God will guide you. Are you walking to the right path? And if not, then God will lead you to the right direction. Amen. Kaya nga po, we need to engage in battle. We do not allow the devil to win over us. We do not allow the devil to win over your family. We do not allow the devil to win over the promises that God has given to you. Amen? Because it is made for you. It is designed for you. It is your benefit. It is the promise of God for you. That's why you need to claim it. Amen? Para sa iyo yun. God designed it for you. That's why we still need to engage. And last but not the least, my third point, amen. Of course, we already sanctified. You already, you know, engaged in spiritual battle. Then of course, what do we need to do? Well, we need to claim the God's promises. It's time to claim it. I don't think when we done the two part, like when we done the first point and the second point, I don't think, you know, you will not get the promises that God has given to you. Amen? Remember, the Lord's promises belongs to believers. Belongs to their children. And if you are the children of God, then you need to claim God's promises. Yun nga lang po, amen, we forfeit our promises, of course, when we have sinned. Kaya nga po, again, in Isaiah chapter 59, verse 2, in the New Living Translation, it says in there, it is your sins that have cut you off from God. Because of your sins, He has turned away and will not listen anymore. So, searching our heart is very important. Amen? Always remember, the Lord will not support our disobedience by blessing us with His promises. The Lord will not support our disobedience by blessing us with His promises. Amen? Because the Bible says, but because the Bible declares in Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13, whoever conceals their sin does not prosper. But the one who confesses and renounces them finds mercy. Amen? Eh kung nagkamali naman tayo, ang dali lang naman eh. Repent. Amen. We need to ask for forgiveness. Pero, God's promises is always true and amen for us, for those who are right with God, those who are doing the will of God. Amen? There's no doubt about it. Because sabi sa Joshua chapter 21, verse 45, Amen. Joshua chapter 21 verse 45. Joshua is, you know, declaring, testifying to the people. Sabi niya, not one of all the Lord's God's promises to Israel failed. Everyone was fulfilled. Amen? It will fulfill. Mabufulfill yan. Basta importante, our standing in the right, in the sight of God. Our standing, when we are standing in front of God and praying, asking for something from God. Ano ba yung puso natin? And for sure, everything that God has promised to you will be fulfilled. As we claim God's promises, amen, and possess the land, He has given us, amen, everything. And as we claim God's promises, amen, we need to claim it with persistence. Sabi mo natin persistence. As we claim God's promises, we need to claim it with persistence. Amen. Why persistence? Because sometimes, you know, prayer, answered in our prayer does not come right away. The first time you pray, there's no answer. Or sometimes it takes months, takes years. But we need to pray to claim it with persistence. Amen? Like I said, we don't give up. We don't give up. And sabi po sa Luke chapter 18 verse 1, we need to keep on praying and not give up. We should always pray and not give up. Tell it to your seatmate again. Don't give up. Keep on praying. Amen? We claim our promises with persistence. And secondly, we need to claim our promises with patience. Sabihin natin patience. Minsan, yung impatience natin, dahil tayong kakaproblema eh. Right? When we become impatient, we do our own thing. Tagal ni Lord. I'm waiting for this work for so long now. Ang tagal. Kaya nag-apply ka na lang ibang work. And then, the work that you have been applied because you are so, you know, hopeless that you need a job, then kahit Sunday, alam mong, you know, may Bible study ka, tinanggap mo pa din. Because you become impatient. But the Bible says, we need to claim our promises with patience. Amen? That's why today, my dear brothers and sisters, what are God's promises to you today? Amen? And as I end, are you ready to possess your land? Knowing that, you know, we need to maintain sanctification, knowing that we need to engage in battle, knowing that we need to claim the promises that God, you know, for you because you are the child of God. It is for you. Amen? Now, are you ready to possess your land? Sabi po sa Hebrews chapter 10 verse 23 as my last verse, last verse ng aking PowerPoint is, let us hold on, let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for He who promised is faithful. Amen? Ang Lord ang nag-promise. He is faithful. He is faithful. He is faithful in our despair, kahit nadi-despair na tayo, He is faithful. He is faithful in our distress. Hindi na tayo makali. He's still faithful. He is faithful in our mistakes. He is faithful in our weaknesses. He is faithful in our difficulties, our sorrow, our hardship. God is faithful. Because the Bible declares in Malachi chapter 3, verse 6a, the Lord says, I am the Lord who does not change. I am the Lord who does not change. Sabi ko ba, Malachi chapter 3, verse 6? The Lord do not change. Even in Joshua chapter 1, verse 5, No one be able to stand against you all the days of your life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. The Creator of heaven and earth has promised and is faithful. If you trust in man, he will disappoint you. But if you trust in God, he will never let you down. Amen? You know, this world is full of uncertainties. Ang dami nangyayari sa mundo. If we are aware of what's happening in the world, right? The war. You know, simula lang, Israel was fighting with Hamas. Ngayon, Hezbollah na. Mga Houthis na. And like countries, you know, there's so much thing that is happening around the world. And last month, our team is, you know, ano ba team natin? Intentional soul winning. Dapat yun ang pinoproblema natin eh. That should be focused on winning people for God. Not anything else. Yun po yung dapat pinagkakabisihan natin as a church. Kaso ang problema, masyado tayong busy sa mga, you know, we're so busy. Ano ba naman yan? Ba't ganyan? Tugtugan nyo. Or ba't ba ganyan? We need to be busy in the kingdom of God. Possessing the land. Soul winning. Those are the things that you need to be busy or for. And like I said, this world is filled with uncertainties. The world is constantly changing. And nothing is permanent anymore. We never know. Maybe God will come tonight. Or tomorrow. Or the next week. Or the next month. And I hope and I pray that all of us, God will find us faithful. Holding on to His promises. Amen? And as my last verse, in Isaiah chapter 55 verse 11, the New Living Translation. It's the same way with my word. I send it out and it always produces fruit. It will accomplish all I want it to and it will prosper everywhere I send it. My dear brothers and sisters, lahat ng salita ng Diyos, it will prosper. Kaya kung ano po yung sinasabi sa inyo ng Lord, whatever God has telling you, amen, it will always produces fruit. Kaya nga po, if it produces fruit, then you know it's from God. But if it's not producing fruit, then maybe it's somewhere else coming from. Amen? Kaya nga po, this world, even though it is uncertain, this world, even though it's not the place to live on anymore. Amen. Maybe we can ask ourselves, is there anything else that's still sure and certain in this world? I believe the answer is yes. Because our God still is faithful. Amen. We just to maintain our course. Sanctification is important. And we need to fight the battle and do not give up. And claim your promises. And for sure, amen, our team, a call to possess the land, will be alive into your life beginning today. Amen? Praise the Lord. Kaya po tayo po tumayo sa mga oras na ito. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord. I know, God, that you have been stored a lot of things to your people today. Because who promises is faithful. And what you have promised a long time ago is the same promise that stood for each and every one of us. That's why today, as we have heard your message today, that one thing that block our promises, one thing that block to possess the land, is because of our disobedience to you. That's why this afternoon, I pray, O God, Lord, that you will continue to search our heart today. Search me, O God, and know my heart today. Ask God to reveal to you if there's anything that is lingering into your heart that will lead you to sin. The devil does not want you to experience abundant things in this world. That's why he will do everything for you not to have it. That's why today, if there's anything in your heart, it's time to ask the Lord for forgiveness. As the Bible declares in 1 John 1:9, that if we confess our sin, He is just and faithful to forgive us and even cleanse us from all of our unrighteousness. My dear brothers and sisters, we need to acknowledge our weaknesses. We need to ask God to give us a new heart, a changed heart, a new mind, a new perspective in life, so that we can truly experience the good things that God has prepared to each and every one of us. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Sikaraya labakanda lalasika. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, continue to touch your people today. Touch their very heart, O God. Encapsulate them with your power, with your grace, with your love, with your mercy. If there's any wicked ways in us, O God, Lord, forgive us so that we can come boldly into your throne of grace. And Lord, hallelujah, as we continue to be cleansed by your blood, as we are continuing to be cleansed by your anointing, O God, Lord, we wage war against darkness, against principalities, against this evil dark world in the name of Jesus. Anything that hinders us, anything that's blocking our answered prayer today, anything that's holding to the promises that God has given to us in the name of Jesus, we cancel any works and plans and attack of Satan in our lives. Yes, cancel it, rebuke it in the name of Jesus. If you have a long-standing prayer, maybe the devil is holding to that promises. Do not allow the devil to steal your joy. Do not allow the devil to steal your peace. Do not allow the devil to steal your hope. Cancel it in the name of Jesus. For no weapons formed against you shall prosper. Yes, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Rebuke it in Jesus' name. You declare war against Satan. You rage war against him. You come against him. Don't be afraid, because God is with you. Greater. Greater. That is in you. That he
he that is in this world, Satan is powerless. He has already been defeated 2,000 years ago. Do not allow him to possess your land, but possess your own land in the name of Jesus. Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah. In Jesus' name, get out of our lives. Get out of your people. Get out of our family. Get out of our relationship. In Jesus' name, you Satan and his cohort, get out of this church. In the name of Jesus, get out of your people. We rebuke you. We have no right in this place. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Yes, and Lord, today we believe, we receive whatever you have promised to us. We claim it, we declare it. It is for us, it is for you. You claim it. Whatever the prayer that you have right now, you claim it and believe it. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. As we continue to worship you, we declare your lordship over our lives.
They say this change will never.
Yes. Hallelujah. That's what the devil is saying.
Know you like we do.
There is power
there
in
is
your name,
power
O God.
In your name.
So much power in your name.
Move the immovable, break the unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe for it.
From the impossible,
we'll see a miracle. God, we believe. God, we believe for it.
Hallelujah, let us sing from the beginning.
They say this mountain can be moved.
Oh, for the Lord, it can be moved.
They say this change will never end.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes, Lord, break the chain right
they
now.
Don't know you like we do.
There is power in your name. There is no way through.
be unbreakable. God, we believe. God, we believe for it. From the impossible, we'll see a miracle.
Yes, Lord, we will hold on to your promises, O God. Whatever the words that you have given to us, Lord, we will hold on to your promises. You have said in your word that every word that you have spoken, it will not come back to you void, but it will accomplish its purpose. That's why, Lord, in the name of Jesus, this evening, this afternoon, oh God, Lord, we are claiming that promises. We believe it, oh God. You said, we believe. You said, we believe.
You said, I believe.
Claim it.
You said,
claim your healing.
It is done.
Claim your prosperity. Claim your blessing. It is for you. It was made for you. It is done. Whatever it is that you're asking for the Lord, it is done. Claim it and believe. Do not doubt, because our God is faithful. Lord, we thank you. Once again, O Lord, you elevated our faith, O God. Thank you, Lord, for your word. And we pray, O God, that this world will not, that this word of yours, O God, will continue to be alive into our hearts, O God. So that whatever that is happening around us, whatever is happening into our lives, whatever circumstances that is happening right now in our lives, Lord, by your word we can discern. By your spirit we can discern. That's why, Lord, we thank you. And once again, oh God, Lord, continue to strengthen us, Lord. Spiritually, strengthen us, oh God. Let the words that we have heard will continue to manifest, so that this life that you have given to us, the life that you have given to your children, O God, we are victorious and not defeated. We will live in this world full of richness. We will live in this world in abundance. Not the material things, Lord, but in abundance of your grace, of your mercy, and even your glory and anointing. That's why, Lord, marami salamat po. Seal, seal, seal all the prayers. Seal all the words to your people, O God, Lord. And do not allow Satan to steal it, to kill it, to destroy it. Yes. in the name of Jesus. Lord, we honor you, we bless you, in Jesus' name. Amen. As we move on to our communion, amen, may we invite all the ushers to come in the front. Amen. Once a month, we commemorate, we remember the Lord's Supper. And that is the command from our God, that we need to remember what God, what Jesus Christ has done in the cross for you and for me. You know, the cross has three important lessons that we need to learn from the Lord's Supper. Before the Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross during the Passover, makikita po natin, the Lord reminded His disciples in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 to 29, that He reminded His disciples to remember what He has done on the cross. Amen? And it's the same command the Lord given to you and to me to remember what He has done on the cross. You know, in these verses, makikita po natin that there are three important lessons that we need to learn from the Lord's Supper. And what is that? First, we need to remember to look within. Ano pong ibig sabihin nun? In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 28 to 29, sabi doon, "But let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks on an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body." So we need to remember to look within. Kanina po, nagpray na tayo, we ask for forgiveness. So I hope, amen, that we are pure in His sight. That's why, but the most important thing is we need to look what's inside our hearts. We cannot just take, you know, the Lord's Supper, if there's any hatred, any anger, any sin into our hearts. That's why we ask for forgiveness. The second thing that we can learn from the Lord's Supper is we need to remember to look back. First, we need to remember to look within, and then we need to look back. Ano po nang ibig sabihin nun? In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, 24, the Bible says, "And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take it, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" So whenever we eat, partake of the bread and drink of the juice, amen, we remember the Lord Jesus Christ, what He has done for you and for me. He gave His life for you and for me so that we can be redeemed, so that we can be saved, so that we can be forgiven, so that we can receive healing, so that we can be, you know, released from any bandage. We need to look back. Amen. And last but not the least is we need to remember to look forward. Sabi po natin, look forward. Amen. Ano ba na ibig sabihin nun? In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 26, it says in there, "For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until He comes." Amen. We are looking forward. You know, because this life here on earth is just temporary. And what we are looking forward is God's return, that when He return, He will find us faithful. Amen? That when He comes back, amen, eh, matatagpuan niyo po tayong tapat. Amen? He will find us faithful until the end. Kaya nga po, amen, as we partake this Holy Communion, eh, we will receive all the benefits of the cross. Amen. Whatever God has done on the cross, it is for us to experience all those things. The benefits of the cross. Amen. Kaya nga po, as we have stretched forth our hand to all these elements, hallelujah, let us pray. Lord, may you continue to bless all these elements, O God, that you have prepared and set before us. Lord, bless the bread that symbolizes your body. Bless the juice, the fruit of the vine that symbolizes your blood. And may this element, O God, to continue, Lord, to give healing. May this element may continue to give deliverance, salvation, and even forgiveness from all of our sin. And we pray, O Lord, hallelujah, as we remember, Lord, what you have done on the cross for us, Lord. We are grateful, O Lord, that you have given your Son, Jesus Christ, to die for us, for our remission of sin, and for the forgiveness of our sin, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we honor you, we bless you, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us all distribute it.
Thank you for the cross, Lord. Thank you for the price you paid, bearing all my sin and shame. In love you Thank you for this love, Lord. Thank you for the nail-pierced hands. Wash me in your cleansing flow. Now all I know, your forgiveness and embrace.
Hallelujah, let us all lift up the bread which symbolizes the body of Jesus. In 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23 to 24, it says in there, "For I received from the Lord what I also pass on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" Let us all partake of the bread. And as we lift up the fruit of the vine that symbolized the blood of Jesus that was shed in the cross of Calvary, in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 25 to 26, "In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.'" Let us all partake of the juice. And let's close in prayer. Hallelujah, Lord. Maraming salamat po for the wonderful things that you have doing in our lives. Truly, O God, that you are good, you never leave us nor forsake us. And there's always word that you are encouraging us. That's why today, may you find us faithful until the end, O God. I pray, O God, that you will continue to uphold your children with your righteous right hand. Protect them always, O God, from the works of the devil. Protect them, Lord, from the snare of Satan. Protect them, O God, Lord. Protect us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. And let your spirit continue to seal us, O God, Lord. The revival fire that we have received last anniversary, O God, let the fire, Lord, surround your people in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I release the blessing that comes from you. Whatever needs of your people today, O God, may it be spiritually, financially, emotionally, mentally, O God, Lord, release unto them the healing in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord, hallelujah, that they will continue to experience abundance, O God, as they continue to follow you and walk with you in the name of Jesus. We release also, O God, Lord, blessings to our loved ones, to our immediate families, whether they are in the Philippines. Lord, give them good health as well, strength that comes from you. Our family, O God, Lord, here in Canada, Lord, may your protection be upon them as well. And may you bind our family with your cords of love that cannot be broken. Lord, maraming salamat po. We declare everything, we believe everything, O God, Lord, that everything that we have already received, O God, because we are your victorious children of God. Lord, maraming salamat po, and to you all the glory, honor, praise, and thanksgiving. In Jesus' name is all we pray. Everybody will say, Amen. Amen.